Today, I'm going to discuss about the topic features of organism. Before entering into the topic, you should know there are five kingdoms. They are animal, plant, fungi, protoctist, prokaryote kingdom. Let's start with the main features of all animals. If you look at this cell, you can see that they are multicellular organisms. When you think about animal cell, always remember they are multicellular. Their cell contains nucleus. You can see that prominent nucleus here. They don't have cell wall. They don't have chloroplast. You don't see chloroplast over here. They feed on organic substances made by other living things. The animal kingdom is classified into two, vertebrates and invertebrates. The character is with backbone and without backbone. If you look at the classes, you can see these classes have backbone. So mammals, fish, birds, reptiles, amphibians have backbone, and these organisms doesn't have backbone. And when you compare between the arthropod and the other classes, you can see that they have, these organisms have legs and the other organisms doesn't have legs. Let's discuss about vertebrates. So there are five classes. The first one is mammal, bird, reptile, amphibian, and fish. So what are the features of mammals? If you look at the feature of the mammal, you can see fur. They have a placenta. They feed young one from mammary glands. They have external ears and they are endothermic. So if you can see the examples, horse, dog, squirrel, and human. So if you look at the bird, you can see that the skin is covered by feather. They have two legs and two wings instead of four limbs. They lay eggs with hard shells on land and they have a beak. So examples, parrot, blue-tit, and eagle. If you look at the class of reptile, you can see dry, fixed scales on skin, lay eggs with rubbery shells on land. See, in the birds, they have hard shells on land, and here in reptiles, you can see rubbery shells on land. Examples are snake, turtle, and iguana. So in amphibians, you can see smooth and moist skin. If you look at the skin comparison, you can see the mammals have fur and the birds have feather and reptiles have scales, and this amphibians have a moist skin. So the adults usually live on land and larvae live in water. So they have gills during the larvae period, and for the adults they have lungs. So they lay eggs without shells in water. So if you think about the egg, in the amphibians there is no shells, whereas in the reptiles you can see shells. Examples are frog, toad, and newt. And in fish you can see loose wet scales on skin, gills to breathe, lay eggs without shells in water. Example, flounder and grouper. Let's see about invertebrate. In invertebrate, you have four classes, myriapods. So the myriapod consists of many segments. Each segment contains at least one pair of jointed legs and one pair of antennae. So example is centipede. The second class is insect. So the insect has three part body, head, thorax, and abdomen. You can see head, thorax, and abdomen. And they have three pairs of jointed legs and two pairs of wings, okay, and you have one pair of antennae. So example is butterfly. So arachnid, so two part body, which means the head and thorax are joined together, so we call that as cephalothorax and abdomen, and they have four pairs of jointed legs and no antennae. Examples is spider. Now if you look at the class of crustacean, you can see that more than four pairs of jointed legs and chalky exoskeleton formed from calcium and which breathe through gills, and they have two pairs of antennae. So example is crab. Now the main features of all plants. So as we discussed in the animals, the same way the plant cells also multicellular. Their cell contains nucleus, chloroplast, and cellulose cell wall. So you can see a very distinct cell wall over here, and you can also see a nucleus, and you can also see chloroplast. Yeah, they all feed by photosynthesis. Ferns. Ferns have leaves called fronds. If you look at this picture, it will be very clear. The fronds contain, you know, you have a blade and a stalk. So what is a frond? The whole fern, leaf, blade and stalk. Okay, so they do not produce flowers, but instead reproduce by spores produced on the underside of the fronds. So if you look at the underside of the frond, you can see some spores that is helpful for the reproduction. Flowering plants. They reproduce sexually by means of flowers and seeds. Seeds are produced inside the ovary found at the base of the flower. So by looking at the flower, you can easily understand the features for the flowering plants. So let's compare the monocotyledon and dicotyledon. If you compare the flower of the monocot and dicot, you can see that the monocot has 3 petals and dicot have 4, or you can see here 5 petals. So mostly multiples of 4 or multiples of 5, you can see it in dicot, or multiples of 3, you can see it in monocotyledon flowers. If you look at the leaves of the dicot and monocot, the monocot leaf is something you can see the veins are parallel. And if you see the leaves of dicotyledon reticulate, which means they have network and webbed veins, you can see the veins here. And if you compare the root system of the monocot and dicot, if you look at the monocot, they are somewhat fibrous root system. And if you look at the dicot, they are tap root system. Our features of all fungi. So example, molds, mushrooms, yeast. So if you look at this cell, usually they are multicellular. And cells have nuclei and cell walls not made up of cellulose. So if you look at this cell wall is made up of chitin. Okay, and if you look at the cell wall of plant, it is cellulose. And they do not photosynthesize. Look at this, there are 2 important points, saprophytic and parasitic. So these fungi eat up the dead material, and for living material, they they will take the nutrient like a parasite. Okay, these are the 2 ways of nutrition for the fungi. Now, the main features of all protoctists are amoeba, paramecium, and plasmodium. Most of the protoctists are unicellular, but some are multicellular. They all have a nucleus. Some may have cell walls and chloroplast. Some protoctists photosynthesize, and some feed on organic substances made by other living things. Features of all prokaryotes. So if you look at the features of prokaryotes like bacteria, blue-green algae, most of them are unicellular. And the cells have cell walls, but it is not made up of cellulose. Some made by polysaccharides. They have a cytoplasm, but no nucleus or mitochondria. The main features of viruses. So viruses are not considered living things. They do not carry out the 7 life process. They take over host cell's metabolic pathway in order to make multiple copies of themselves. Viruses RNA or DNA inside the protein code. If you look at this virus picture, you can see that the viral DNA is inside and they have a capsid protein. And see, if you look at this 2 important points, they are not considered as a living things. If you look at the video 1.1, you will get to know much about this concept. Okay, let me ask you a question. What are the features this organism possess? By looking at this organism, you can comment on it. If you like this video, click the like button and share it with your friends. Subscribe to my channel for more videos. Thank you.